Sadanand Gowda being moved to statistics from law. Jayant Sinha has also been moved out of the finance portfolio, and he's been given civil aviation, MG Akbar, MOS, MEA. These are pretty big changes. The reshuffle is actually a bigger headline today than the expansion.
Actually, Nidhi, you know, I did feel from the morning, given the kind of people who inducted in, most of them really non-entities, people we've never heard of, some of them first-time MPs with no really record of any kind of administrative expertise. So, you know, the thing was to really watch out for the change in portfolios, which happened very late in the evening. And it's interesting that it's taken all this time for the government to announce the change in portfolios, which I think indicates that there was a lot of to-ing and fro-ing, a lot of discussion that went on before the announcement was made. Now, what does this mean? I think Rahul Srivastava has raised some very interesting questions about Smriti Irani's, you know, the change of Smriti Irani's portfolio. You know, and it's interesting that both the HRD ministers, you know, have been changed. Do you know, do you realize that? Because Smriti Irani is gone to textiles, and the Minister of State has been dropped. So was there a problem with the way the HRD ministry was functioning? Is that why this has happened? Or is there a political role awaiting both of them, both Dr. Kataria and Smriti Irani, a political role for UP, which Amit Shah will unfurl in the next few weeks? I think we have to wait and see that.
All right, Sambit Patra, let me ask you for your, you know, first comment from the BJP there. Major changes. So how would you first look at, you know, Smriti Irani being moved out of the HRD ministry, since all of you have so, you know, strongly batted for her in TV studios after with one controversy and after another in the ministry throughout the past couple of years? What is the message that the Prime Minister has sent today?
The first thing, as far as you saying that Smriti Irani had to bat through a number of controversy and we were defending her, it's absolutely wrong. She is one of the young, suave faces of Bharatiya Janata Party who has always stood the test of time and who has shown as to how, without the backing of any kind of political generations, I mean, she doesn't come from a very politically, she doesn't come from a well-to-do family, from an ordinary family, how she has traveled this far is absolutely applauding. We should applaud that. But as far as the present discussion is concerned, as far as the rejig is concerned, I would say I've been hearing Mr. Rahul Srivastava, I've been hearing you and Aarti Jarath as well. I would say this is speculation versus strategy. Speculation in the sense you all have been speculating number of things, that maybe it is because of this, maybe it because of UP, and this strategy. Party may be doing this for a strategy. Why should I buy anything out of this? I would say HRD is as important as textile, or rather textile is as important as HRD.
No, but what is
working
the
in any ministry and proving the metal is what important.
If she was doing so fantastically well in the HRD ministry, which is a very crucial portfolio, Sambit, why was she moved out? Why was she moved out? You know, is there a sense in the government that the controversies and the headlines were adversely affecting the ministry and its work?
No, I would not say that. That's your speculation. I was just listening to most of your speculations on this. There were a number of speculations that you made, that probably this was the issue, probably that was the issue. I would say, well, strategy was also one of your speculations. Might be, keeping Uttar Pradesh in mind, this was a strategy. This is also one of your speculations. I would not speculate. I would refrain from any kind of speculation. This is the prerogative of the Prime Minister to expand the cabinet and to reshuffle the cabinet is the absolute prerogative of the Prime Minister. I would not comment on that. And as far as Smriti Irani's performance is concerned, she has always been an encouraging face of Bharatiya Janata Party, and she would continue to be so.
Abhishek Singhvi of the Congress Party also joining us. Let me get the first opposition reaction to this, Abhishek Singhvi, because the criticism of the opposition on the cabinet expansion today was largely I think Aarti Jarath alluded to that, that, you know, there was unknown faces, there was no real shifting of people, portfolios, you know, we didn't know what portfolios were going to be changed. But when you look at this reshuffle in the evening today, it's a very significant change that has happened, you know, important ministries where we've seen people being moved around. And isn't that a good thing? That means there is accountability, and the Prime Minister has taken note of that.
Nidhi, I am handicapped in as much as this has happened almost in the middle of the programs I've been on. So I don't have a full list. I'm not fully aware of the changes, though I've heard some of them from you. But I want to make a few, and obviously it is always a prerogative of the Prime Minister to decide what portfolio you hold, what you don't hold. That's not the point at all, however, Nidhi. The real point is, I think, that A, the Prime Minister by omission has sent a clear message of endorsement and complicity in that he has taken no action against the great eminence greases of Sadhvi Jyoti, Giriraj Singh, Sanjeev Balyan, Mahesh Sharma, the kind of antics, or for that matter Mr. V.K. Singh, the kind of antics, statements, events these people have generated have led to eloquent silence earlier, and now was the time to send a message. There is even greater silence now. No punishment, no punitive action, nothing. Number two, this is clearly nothing to do with talent. All this leakages in the press about great talent and great search and all this performance based, it is nothing but a cabinet rejig by the party president Amit Shah with UP, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat in mind in particular, and the declining graphs in particular in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh, and a gearing up for the UP elections. That's very clear from the combination of the names, and I don't need to go through that. Third, I think it continues to be a cabinet or a group of ministers largely of anonymities, not a single person who can even look the Prime Minister in the eye. And that's the real point, Nidhi. It's an over-centralized approach which this Prime Minister has. He has made it a one-man show. The one-man show goes to the fact that,
you know, there may be a lot of people who've been inducted today who folks don't know or haven't been familiar with in the headlines. But you know, it's interesting. Many of the new ministers who've taken oath today, Aarti Jairath and Shahid Siddiqui also joining us, they have a more than 90% attendance in Parliament. I mean, that tells you something about the kind of record that they have as far as their parliamentary work is concerned. Maybe it's not fair to judge them on their work now when they've only just taken oath. But let me ask Shahid Siddiqui.
I have not said a word. I am saying none of these people matter in terms of giving a input of a contrary kind, standing up to the Prime Minister, looking him in the eye, because this Prime Minister functions on over-centralization.
Sambit, quickly, I want to go to Shahid. Yes.
No, with all due respect to what Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi has been saying, that none of these people matter because none of them can look eye to eye with the Prime Minister, I would say, please, with all due respect to Manmohan Singh, he could not even look eye to eye to Sonia Gandhi. Forget about the ministers. We had a Prime Minister for 10 years who never knew that the prerogative of the Prime Minister was to expand the cabinet. So please, for God's sake, don't reduce the Prime Minister's position to such diminutivthat you can say that none can look eye to eye to Prime Minister. He's an ordinary chaiwala. Anyone can look eye to eye to him and can advise him, can take advice from him. That is the difference between the Prime Minister then and the Prime Minister now.
Shahid Siddiqui, your first thoughts on this reshuffle?
No answer to oversimplify.
No, Shahid Siddiqui, on the reshuffle itself, Shahid, and Smriti Irani's being dropped from HRD.
I have missed the debate, so I exactly don't know what is the reshuffle. But the only thing I know is that Mr. Javedkar has taken over from Smriti Irani. That is the only bit I could gather, and I think that's a very important change. But I feel that that change is with a view to UP elections, and Smriti Irani may be sent to Uttar Pradesh to lead the party there. So it's not because the Prime Minister thought that she was not doing the job properly. It's because of the political reasons. So whole reshuffle, whole, you know, expansion is with elections in mind, and it's a political expansion. It's not much to do with administrative reasons. So, and I think that's the prerogative of any political party or a Prime Minister. So we shouldn't really complain that it's a political expansion and it's not about talent. Of course, politics is always paramount in this kind of expansions. This happened with UPA. This is happening now. But I think this is a very, very important move which has taken place today.
Well, the point is, Shahid, if I may say so, that okay, even if Smriti Irani was being moved out for a political role in Uttar Pradesh, she could have been given any other, for want of a better word, high-profile ministry. She's been moved to textiles. What does that say? There's a message that is being sent out here.
No, I don't know what the message is. If the message was to be there, then it should have been with many other ministers. the agriculture ministers were not doing very well. As Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi mentioned, all these ministers who were speaking out of turn, all these ministers who were embarrassing Prime Minister Modi, all these ministers who were creating controversies, some of them should have been.
That's right. They're still there.
But that has not happened. And therefore, just to think that Smriti Irani, I think, was doing a good job for RSS and BJP.
No, so I just wanted Aarti to weigh in on that.
Then, actually, Nidhi, whether Smriti Irani is declared the CM candidate of the BJP for UP or not, I mean, I think it looks to me like they're planning a fairly major role in campaigning, at least for Smriti Irani, and she's a good campaigner. And, particularly if Priyanka comes in or, and Rahul plays a big role in UP, I mean, Smriti is an effective counter from the BJP. I mean, obviously she needs a light ministry because she cannot campaign, say, do something like 155 rallies in UP if she's got a heavyweight ministry. So she had to be given a lightweight ministry, like textiles. I mean, textiles is really not, it's not really, a ministry that is time-consuming. It's often been an additional charge.
But HRD is a very important portfolio.
It is, absolutely. So that is why they've given it to, that Prakash Chandrekar has been promoted. And Prakash, I don't know whether it's important or not, but I think the main idea, if at all this UP thing happens, because we're really speculating right now, we have absolutely no idea till an announcement comes from the party, and there is some kind of a rejig about to happen in the party as well. We don't know whether it's going to happen tomorrow or later this month or whatever, but there is some kind of an organizational rejig happening, and they do have to make an announcement as far as UP is concerned. This is a debate that has been going on in the BJP for the past 2 months on whether they should have a CM face or not, who should lead the campaign.
I want to ask Abhishek Singhvi on that. If Smriti Irani does end up playing a bigger political role in UP and campaigning for the BJP, would you concede that she is a formidable campaigner? And there is talk and all kinds of speculation today about Priyanka Gandhi possibly playing a bigger role in UP as well.
Well, I don't understand how this extrapolation is done. I think it's an oversimplistic, over facile assumption. Smriti Irani is a complete newcomer to UP. She has no connection with UP. She may have been sent there for histrionics to fight the election against the Gandhis. But beyond that, nothing much ever has happened with her. She is known to do histrionics. She is known to get some attention. But I doubt very much if the profile in UP helps to get votes. Yes, you can rely upon this to get lots of media attention, lots of histrionics, lots of drama. But I think beyond that, I fail to understand anybody seeing her as a winning candidate or a winning input for UP. Secondly, I would understand that to be more likely if she was dropped altogether and immediately entrusted with a party post. To be given a lighter portfolio sounds to me like a demotion.
Okay, sounds to you like a demotion. Sambit wanted to come in on that. Yeah, Sambit, why not just then drop her and then announce a bigger role for her, for Uttar Pradesh, in the next couple of weeks or so?
See, as far as Smriti Irani's rejig is concerned, I have been very carefully listening to the debate and the discussion going on right now with you. And I'm astonished. I told you, this whole thing is an oscillation between speculations at one end and the speculations at the other end. And right now, Aarti Jarath rightly put it, these all are speculations. So why should I sell myself to the speculations? Media has a right to speculate. You should. My duty is not to give away the strategy of the party. I should be behaving as a spokesperson of the party, which I am doing. But buying some points from what Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi threw at me right now, he said that Smriti Irani is a newcomer. I am in fact tempted to quote what Priyanka Gandhi had said in 2014 when she was asked about Smriti Irani. She had classically said, "Who's Smriti?" Do you remember, Nidhi, what Priyanka had said? Who's Smriti? She did not even know who Smriti Irani was. And the same Smriti Irani gave the kind of fight to Rahul Gandhi, which Rahul Gandhi will remember his whole life. And I tell you, the same Smriti Irani will make Rahul Gandhi cry for his votes in the next election from his own constituency. Mark my words.
I think Priyanka Gandhi did know who Smriti Irani was. I think she was being sarcastic. I don't think she didn't know. But the point is, it would be a very interesting
battle. Even I'm sarcastic. Don't worry.
No. So, Shahid, wouldn't it be an interesting battle if this was the case? Shahid Siddiqui, if it is, if you see Priyanka Gandhi campaigning outside of Amethi and Raibareli, which is likely to happen, we don't know the extent to which it will happen. And you have Smriti Irani as sort of one of the lead campaigners for the BJP at the very least. Would that make this battle for UP interesting?
Absolutely. Smriti Irani may not command great support base in Uttar Pradesh, but she is a good campaigner. She is a hard campaigner, and she was sent earlier to nail down Rahul Gandhi, and she will be a real thorn for Priyanka Gandhi, because putting a woman like Smriti Irani before Priyanka Gandhi will be a real challenge. And I'm not saying that Smriti Irani is a great, very popular leader in UP. She is not, but she is one who can really fight back and who can create a drama. And that, and in politics, drama sometimes works, and it works to slow down your opponent. So that may be the strategy. She may not be the chief ministerial candidate, but she may be the one of the main campaigners in UP.
Well, you also need drama for
Nidhi. Just one second,
Sambit. The thing is that both the Congress and the BJP seem to be aiming at a battle for the in front of the media. The real battle is being fought on the ground between the BSP and the SP. These guys will fight it out on television.
Absolutely.
For our entertainment.
But there are other important changes as well.
Just Nidhi, before I leave, I need just 10 seconds,
yeah,
please,
yeah,
Nidhi.
Yeah, go ahead, Sambit.
Anidhi, I heard Abhishek Manu Singhvi as well as the very erudite Mr. Shahid Siddiqui. But both use the same word, that is drama. I did not expect this from Mr. Siddiqui. He said that Smriti may throw up a good drama in Uttar Pradesh. I'll tell you what the real definition of drama is. Drama lies with the manufactured leader.
I understand that.
Let me just put my answer. I'll define what drama is. Drama is when you put up a political role of yourself as a manufactured leader for only 15 days in your own constituencies. You attire yourself in a particular manner, you speak in a particular manner, and thereafter you shed all that to be what you are really. Priyanka does exactly that. Just a manufactured leader for 15 days, that is all. As far as Smriti is concerned, a transition from an ordinary woman till this is not drama, that is hard work. It is only through hard work that this can be achieved, not through drama, sir. Drama is when Gandhi name is attached and you act as if you are a great leader.
Sambit, you would welcome Priyanka Gandhi campaigning in UP then? That should suit you.
We welcome the Gandhi family. We will be the happiest people if Rahul Gandhi and his family are the ones who stay at the helm of affair of Congress.
Abhishek Singhvi, quick last word before I take a break.
I have no reason to reply to rhetoric. He's always abusing either the individual panelists or the topic. So I don't think I want to dignify this with a reply.
You spoke about drama, I was replying to what drama is.
All right, Aarti and Shahid, quick last word.
Yeah,
you
can reply to it.
Hardly
matters.
The portfolios. We'll take a break and we're going to continue to focus on this story. Jayant Sinha being moved out of finance. Why do you think that happened? Because he seemed to be doing all right. Nobody was thinking of him getting moved out.
I know. And in fact, actually, if the Prime Minister really wanted to reward performance, I think Jayant Sinha should have been given an elevation. Maybe should have been made Minister of State with independent charge and been given a high-profile portfolio. So I cannot understand.
He's been moved to civil aviation.
But there's a minister there already. It's not that he's been given independent charge of civil aviation.
As far as I know.
So
yeah.
As an MOS civil aviation, compared to MOS finance, I mean, finance was definitely higher profile than civil aviation. So, I mean, on the face of it, it would seem to be a demotion.
And Venkaiah Naidu, is now confirmed, is holding the INB portfolio as well. Why was it difficult for Arun Jaitley to continue with both the finance ministry, corporate affairs, and this? Was it just becoming too much?
Well, finance The economy is the government's biggest challenge today. I mean, they need to start delivering, they need to turn the economy around. I mean, they quote all these figures about GDP growth and so on and so forth, but it's not translating into reality on the ground. There are no visible results of whatever they're doing. So I think it's the biggest challenge for the government today, and I think it needs all of Arun Jaitley's time, energy and expertise to concentrate on that portfolio. I really don't think he has the time to devote to INB, which, mind you, although I remember Prakash Javdekar had right at the beginning when the government was formed said the INB ministry should be wound up because it's such a useless portfolio. But somehow it seems to have become very, very important for this government. You know, they're talking about communication, they're talking about getting the message across.
Is Venkaiah Naidu the best person for that? Honestly?
Well, I think we'll have to wait and see.
All right, I'm going to take a break. We'll be back at the top of the hour in just a couple of minutes. Shahid Siddiqui and Aarti Jairath will be staying with us as we look at the other portfolios as well and what the political implications of this reshuffle will be. Do join us at 10 o'clock. Mm-hmm.